Hi, guys. It's that time of day. I said that a girl named Donna asked me to do the video at this time of night, and I said for fine to do that. Unfortunately, my headphones are slipping. So let me try to adjust these so they don't slip quite as bad. That's about as good as it's gonna get. And it's this side staying good and strong, but this side sliding all over the place. So let me see if I can find a way to secure that. Is there any junk in here? There's junk. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is let me go get some electrical tape, and I'm gonna put some tape on those headphones. So, and also put some electrical tape on the other equipment so that we don't have problems. The headphones keep sliding down. I got a small head, and so I tend to, my headphones sometimes slip. And Dory's here in the other room. She's going to be answering your phone calls, and then she'll transfer them to me. And if hopefully things will go fine this time, and we'll start by giving you the phone number. It's 860-738-8463, and so that's the number you can call. Call now while the rates are low. Okay, so I'm just putting some pieces of tape on that cord here so that I can keep this thing from sliding down. Like, while the side doesn't seem to be skipping as bad, it's just the same thing on the other side here to keep some symmetry to the headphones, so at least they don't look too bad. Okay, so I'm just doing is I'm putting some electrical tape on them so that we can actually make sure that they don't slide down. Remember, we were also having problems with the headphone jack too, so I'm going to put a piece of electrical tape on that as well so that... Okay. Ah, it's much better. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we have our phones on. We have the cord. The cord, yes. Okay, let me put some tape on that so that the cord doesn't get ripped out of the socket. Or pulled out, anyway. I mean, not ripped, but... Today we had gotten some things to do, and one of the things is we got our CanSee eye drops today, so we were able to prepare our eyes so we can actually do things. It's gonna be pretty good. You think so? Yeah. Because this... Okay, it's gonna stay in place anyway. Yeah. Okay, so we're gonna start with the phone numbers. Our phones are online right now. Unfortunately, Dory left all her stuff here on the table, so it looks kind of haphazard, and that's what happens. So, and you can hear our phones are loud. They are brought to you. Service is brought to you this time by Frontier Telecommunications, that's the local analog telephone in Connecticut. And we, of course, will be watching everything. And I'm going to go ahead and check and see how we're doing in the browser on the phone here. We have the computer on over there in the corner so that we can watch that stream as well. So we have that one, the Intel iMac. Intel Core 2 Duo machine is being used to monitor the sound to make sure that the sound is making the proper sounds. In other words, make sure that the soundtrack is working, and I did check it, and it is. And that's always important, because one of the things that we run into sometimes when you're doing YouTube videos is that there's no room for any kind of discrepancy. It's totally it's mind-blowing to realize that when you're doing a video on this channel, especially live streams, there's some really big things, challenges ahead that can really throw a lot of complications your way. Like as we found out with the IRA pre, which then has to sound when record, or as it may happen one sooner or later, that the battery in the IRA pre is going to run down, run flat, and I'm going to need to replace it. I'm going to get some more batteries soon. This battery here is a newer battery. It was, I do have the old battery just in case I need it. So, right now I have two viewers. I'm one at home on this computer, and of course somebody else is out there. Congratulations to that person. I want you to know that I am very much, oh, that was from this afternoon. Oh, okay. So, I sure got the wrong one. I got the wrong one. Yes, I did. Alright, so let's go to the live stream. I have to admit, it would have been nice if that was actually the live now. But you know what? It's not. No, it's not. I got three watchers, so it's one better. It's one better. Alright, so today, of course, we hope to hear from Darlene, Anita, Donna, and other people. So, hopefully you guys... we'll get back to me and we can all kind of have a chat. This time, at least on our side of the system, there should be no reason why your phone call should be turned in to Shishami. It will be a phone call and it will be in its entirety. I got these cookies from the pharmacy. From the bakery. I don't know if this is from Stop and Shop or from, where they're from. The soup kitchen gave them to me. They're just chocolate chip chunk cookies. And, they call them chocolate chip, but when you look at them, the in-house camera, we're recording this simultaneously. These things are huge chunks. They're not chips in a sense. These look like chocolate chunks, not chips. Kind of a soft base. So, give me an idea what they taste like. Now, so, that's cool then. If Jennifer says, eating a cookie on camera is not professional. So, there's some chewing on my muscles. Okay, so, anyway, we are live, and that's exciting. And, well, I'd still like to hear you guys call. Dory is monitoring the phones. And, things like that. Dory, do we have any phone calls yet?
Nope.
Do we have any messages yet?
Oh, wait a minute. Donna. Hi, Michelle.
Go ahead.
Donna said hi. She said, how are you?
I'm real fine. I'm doing okay. And that's from who now?
From Donna.
Okay.
I am doing fine.
For those of you who wonder how I'm typing when I'm in the other room here, Dory's actually typing it. Dory has problems with dyslexia, so sometimes she gets messages wrong. Just be patient. That's why I have the other computer on, so I can check it out at the same time that she is. Now, Donna, is there anything that you'd like to discuss?
All right. Donna, is there anything you like to to talk about.
Well, I can think of one thing. That one representative there, what's her name there? Maxine Walters. She said something really interesting. Michelle, explain. On MSNBC.
Michelle? What was this?
What'd she say?
She said, your show is great.
Well, I just started, so let's see how we go. We're going to talk first about, just let her know thank you and that keep watching because we've got more coming up. Maxine Waters, that's Waters, not Walters, today, actually yesterday on CNBC, dropped a real big goober on the people. She... In her crazy mind state, she's as crazy as a fox in some ways. She said, and she's a Democrat now, that Barack Obama authorized the spying on Donald Trump. Now, I have to tell you that I think that's disgusting. I think Donald Trump should get rid of every single Democrat in authority in the office and give them all their termination notices. Just get rid of all of them because they're all part of the swamp. They're all part of the swamp. They're the alligators that are trying to bite his ass. So you got that right. So absolutely. Those are the alligators that are trying to bite Donald Trump in his privates. So yes, as part of the FBI through congressional review, there should definitely be somebody.
Michelle?
Yep, go ahead.
She asked did you hear Luke Bryan's latest song?
Whose latest song?
Luke Bryan's, I think she's saying.
Let me check. Hold on a minute. See, I can check on the other screen myself. So I can't really say I've heard it. I don't usually listen to the radio much. Because the only radio station we get around here is AM 1610, which is my radio station. It's mostly a news channel. And then that broadcasts pretty much through the building and the backyard. So, no, I don't know who Luke Bryan is. I would suspect, from what you told me, you are, it's a country singer. Sounds like it. You're right, I think it is. Okay. So, no, I have not heard the latest song by Luke Bryan. By the way, I mentioned a song in yesterday's vlog called Limbo Rock. And for those of you who do not know it, the original by Chubby Checker was released in 1962. And then there was a couple remakes of the song that because of the DMCA, I cannot play on this station here. And there's a really awesome one from in a foreign language. I don't know if it's Portuguese. It looks like Portuguese. It looks like it's the same language that Barbara Paola uses when she talks in Google Plus. So it may very well be Portuguese. It's done by a series of young boys and girls, I'd say probably about 7 to 10 years old. And it's really kind of cute. And then there is another... it's more of an instrumental piece of music by another performer. I can give you the name of the performer. So let me go to... let me go back to my YouTube channel's history. And I can pull up the names of these performers. So let me see if I can find them for you. And let's see. Some would say is that...
I think you're... Wait 2 minutes.
Continue. Sometimes the system sucks. Well, that's one of the reasons why I would like to get a new BlackBerry Key 1, because this phone is a bit old and it doesn't work too good with some applications on the web, and YouTube is one of them. And so that's the reason why I've been looking forward to getting a... So let's go to the history. And let's take and see if I can pull up the singers here. Let's see. 33-year-old bear. Listening to screen stamps. Okay. I was checking out something called Jazzercise, too, but let's see. It's called Perlice. P-E-R-L-I-C-E. Says P-E-R-L-I-C-E. They're doing Limbo Rock. Perlice also did Footloose. And then Perlice does the Macarena. Pretty cute. It's a single dancer doing the Macarena. And then, of course, here's another Limbo Rock challenge that involves cars. That was boring. That was really boring. There was also one by Ta Zal Zovonia. Ta Zal Zovonia. It's Greek. What do you want? Really cool Greek. Really awesome. So, and then of course, there's also a few other songs I was looking at too. The original Chubby Checker from 1962, and a few other things. Cool. And so, any new messages, Dory?
Yeah, I'm still talking to Dawn. I'm trying to get her to call you, but she's a little nervous. Does Michelle's system on you now? No.
Probably. She said, I think she said she was going to be too busy to actually call, because she said she has to make sure to pick her husband up from work. So she may not be able to call right now. But tell her that we're on until 6 o'clock so she can try to squeeze in before 6. That would be fine. Yeah, absolutely. And of course, what about the Anita that wanted to talk about TRAPPIST 1 and the 7 rocky plants discovered around TRAPPIST 1? A little background about TRAPPIST-1 is it is a solar system not too far away from us. It is, the star itself is a red dwarf, so it's got more of a red shift to it. And what's important to know about the star is that because it's not as hot as our sun, the planets, even though they're closer to the sun, the star, or their sun, are, for all intents and purposes, are, you know, they're just about the right temperature based on the actual energy output of their sun.
Right.
They believe 3 of them may very well be in the Goldilocks zone to support life. NASA has said that they're going to need to do more research into that to determine, what the likeliness of life is. Please understand that this is something that's going to take a while. Our government is not exactly the fastest thing in the world in the space exploration. But we do know that the new situation with the new solar rockets. I mentioned about the SpaceX rocket a couple days ago. That SpaceX has said that they're going to be launching a new mission to the moon as a tourist run. In other words, that they will go around the moon in a SpaceX rocket with 2 paying passengers aboard. Okay? Sightseeing, basically. Oh, nice. Obviously, they're paying their own way. Okay? NASA had planned on the... their first new rocket ship that they were building, the first test run was supposed to be EM-1, which was supposed to occur around 2018. Well, at this point, what's happening is is that the people at NASA decided that, hey, Donald Trump said to NASA, said, hey, could you put people on that first mission? It would be so awesome. I mean, it'll be more risky, but hey, you know, I'd like to see people go to the moon. So he wants to have them put, at first they're going to start with a, what they call low Earth orbit, or LEO, and then they're going to, as long as the rocket is working correctly, and there's no foreseen bad problems, they hope to go ahead and make things go a bit faster, and actually go ahead into the orbital launch to get to the moon. Kind of be more like an Apollo mission. In fact, it's using an Apollo-type capsule, but it would be with more modern technology. I'm not using things like the old Apollo launch computer, which I know that Fran Blanche was going to build a display for the original Apollo computer, navigation computer. She never did finish it because she said the problem was is the cost of the materials, especially for the luminescent display. But she said it was really kind of cool to see what it would look like. And she got a chance to look at the actual unit that was sitting in storage. I forget what they call it. Well, basically, it's a launch computer.
Michelle?
Go ahead.
All right, listen. I don't know. I don't think Donald wants to call in. But she wanted me to ask you, did you see Florida and Georgia's lines per Fensley in Atlanta?
Excuse me?
Oh, God. This is why I hate doing this.
Well, I know. I can check over here, too, Dory, so I don't have to worry about messing it up. Let me just check it real quick. Did you see Florida's Georgia Line's performance in Atlanta? No, I haven't been to Atlanta in, since 1992. So that was the last time I was in Atlanta, was in around 1992, 1993. So no, I did not. Okay, but you're doing fine, Dory, don't worry about it. You know, you're doing fine. This is a chance for Dory, too, so give Dory a hand. She's really trying her best, to deal with something that is really, really out of her comfort zone. Normally when she goes to, Primetime House in the daytime, she makes, greeting cards, for members, and get well cards and things. And we have a personal house call.
Hello.
Let me take care of that. Oh, Dory's got
Hello.
It. Who is it, Dory? Who is it, Dory?
Okay.
We'll find out. See, now that call I just came in is on our personal line. And it's not our studio line. So that's a different line. So when you guys call, be aware that you may hear the phone ring. It may not necessarily be you, for you, or from you. It's just obviously from other people. Who was that, Dory?
I think it was this kid, Lou Shuck, whatever the hell his name is. He's being very rude, disrespectful.
Oh, one of those kind, huh?
Yeah, and I wasn't putting it through because he was not saying very nice things.
Please be understanding that Dory is trying to help out here to keep things organized. As far as the people that are not being respectful of us, you guys are making a horrible example of yourself. And that's why Dory is there, is so that we can try to keep things from getting too nuts. All right,
Michelle, I don't know what this guy said, but he said, don't talk down to my broadcast. That's that Lou guy. He says, don't talk down to my broadcast.
Don't talk down to my broadcast. Huh. I don't know what that means. I don't know what that means yet. Let me look and see if I can see if there's a trick. Okay. He said, well, that was immature. Lou Skunt says, don't talk down to my broadcast. Well, first of all, Lou, we're not trying to talk down to your broadcast. Like I said, we have two things going on simultaneously. Some people, I have to admit, don't like to call because they're very self-conscious. And we understand that. Okay, some people rather type because maybe they can't hear. I know I can't hear everybody. So, because of hearing loss, if you want to type it, that's fine. Dory will do her best to read it. And I will occasionally look over it as well. In fact, it's the best I can do. It's not the greatest idea. It's not the worst. It's not the worst. But let me ask you a hypothetical example, which doesn't apply right now to you. But because by the time we get to this point, it'll probably be many decades away, if not longer. What's that? What if we eventually get to the star TRAPPIST-1, set up a colony on TRAPPIST-1? Would people be able to listen to our YouTube videos? But yeah, it depends on how many light years is that from us? I think it's something like 3540. So in about 3540 years, yes, in 35 years... And I got a phone call online.
Hi, how can I help you?
Yeah, in about 35, 40 years, they will be able to catch this stream from the satellites on YouTube by the time it gets to TRAPPIST-1. So yeah, by that time you try to call into our studio, I'll be long gone. Yeah. And so then poor sod in 35 years will be wondering why you keep calling her phone number. That's a great point. Absolutely. Absolutely. And, so I'm going to just see, anything new, Dory, coming up on the computer?
No, just that moron.
Oh, well, what's he saying?
He said what he said, and then he just called back, and Donna commented, well, she commented, and then I wrote to Donna, and I said, thank you for saying that, Donna. And she wrote, I love you guys. Donna wrote, I love you guys.
Okay, well, thank you, Donna. We appreciate that. In fact, Dory, you want to take turns and sit down here in the hot seat for a little bit?
Sure. And the other guy says, you got beat.
All right, so what I'm going to do is I'll take the calls this time, and Dory will be here in the studio for a little while. So I'm going to switch over to the other room, and she'll be sitting here on the couch for a little bit. Because I told her we'd take turns at this so that you get a chance to talk to Dory and hear what she's got to say. And for people like Lou Skunt, you're certainly welcome to call. I just, ask you to have a little empathy. So why don't you come on out here, Dory?
Watch my phones over there.
Okay, here's the headphones. Please don't adjust them. They're already preset. If you adjust them, it's just going to make a mess of them. Okay?
Oh, this is loud.
Okay, so the first thing I do is let me make a quick commercial break and I'll be right back. Go ahead, Dory, you can start talking.
Hi, my name is Dory. I'm here to help Michelle. And I don't know really, Donna was talking about what happened in Florida and in Georgia going to Atlanta. If she would like to call and talk about that she says she's a little shy, but I was shy for the very first time talking on here too. And I'll be ready now. Go ahead, put it on speaker.
Hi, can I help you? I don't know who that's. This is Luke. He keeps calling in and doing that.
What's he doing?
He keeps calling in and just screeching in the phone.
Well, tell him to turn his computer down when he calls.
Luke, if you want to talk to us, turn your computer down when you call. So we can understand you.
Does, we do get that kind of echo back.
So we don't hear your screeching little crying little voice.
Okay.
And we're not trying to ruin your show. We're not trying to say that. I don't know how you can say that we're trying to ruin your show. I never even heard of you before, but that's okay. But I wasn't really listening to what Michele talked about, but I do know that I would like to talk about how much Michele really, really puts an effort into all these shows that she has done. She really cares about people. People are her, she enjoys people. She really likes to make people feel welcome in different worlds and different kinds of stuff like that. So please don't make fun of her, because she really, really puts...
Our show is our beefing night.
What?
He said, our shows are beefing now. I heard what Dory said. I don't know what that means, but...
What do you mean by our shows are beefing now?
Are you saying, Colin, you are simulcasting this program on your program?
But, like I said, Michele really does put an effort into all this stuff. I mean, if you were to come into Michele's home and see what she has to do this. She has like a computer in her room. She has a computer over there. She has like a whole phone line so she can do this. She has all kinds of stuff. So I mean, she really puts her work into this.
Okay. I just want to explain what Lou was talking about, Doreen. Lewis Gunn was trying to explain is that he's kind of simulcasting this broadcast on his broadcast on his YouTube channel. And so that's why he said, don't talk down to my broadcast now. So I thought I would take the chance to explain that. Well, it might be getting a little confusing because he's actually simulcasting our broadcast on his channel's broadcast.
Is that illegal?
Which means he's relaying our channel program on his channel's program.
Okay. Okay. But does anyone have any questions?
I'm reading what somebody said, what Donna said to Lou. She says, Michele has a show, Lou. You are just a joke. Well, I don't know, Donna. That's a great question because I can't tell if it's a joke or not.
Well, I have to agree with Donna because this guy has been a thorn in your backside since you started these.
One moment. Yes, can I help you? Yeah, hold on a minute. Let me cancel the studio, okay? Let me pull it. Hey, Dory, it's you.
Hi. Hi, can I help you?
Turn down your volume. It's against the car. It's kind of confusing. That's what that is, Dory. It's feedback from the system. There's a looping problem.
What I just said.
if you want us to hear you, you have to turn your stuff down. We can't hear you correctly.
Pick up the handset, Dory. It's the only way you're going to break the chain.
Hello? Hi. Thank you. Have a good night.
Okay.
See, callers like that I don't like because it makes Michelle not.
Yeah, I know. He's apparently relaying our show to his show, which is causing some kind of a loop problem because he's not keeping his speakers turned down. So when he calls our show, what's happening is his sound is repeating everything that we said like a couple milliseconds after we said it, and then when we get it, it repeats it back to him a couple milliseconds later.
Oh, okay. But
it's kind of like biofeedback when you hear when the microphone squeal, but there's just a longer delay between the feedback.
All right, well, okay, I guess so. But okay. I really want to talk about Tadano, because when I was in there doing the typing, she mentioned something about Florida, Orlando, and Georgia. I like to know what that
she
was.
She says, put you on air, but you keep creating feedback loop issue. Turn our speakers down, please. Okay. He says to me, put me on the air or I'm going to keep calling my music. Well, Lil, let me answer that question right now. I would put you on the air, but the problem is that we got a feedback loop problem. Otherwise, I'd put you on the air. And we did put you on the air, and there was a loop. It was constantly just looping. So you need to do also, and this applies to any callers, please turn down your speakers when you call to prevent that kind of delayed loop, because it's really, really confusing to our phone system, because we can't, the speakerphone seizes up when you do that, and we can't even say a piece because it blocks everything. So that's the reason why we ask you to please turn your speakers down to call in. And don't worry about it, because you will be recorded on the air. You will have your piece. And don't forget, you can watch the replay later on today. We also have the other camera running simultaneously. So we will have the backup of the standard PAL feed, standard definition as well, which I have to check and see how that's doing.
Okay. Michelle, can you please, Donna.
What's that?
Donna, she had talked about something happening in Florida and Georgia in Atlanta, the airlines. Can you ask her what that was about? And so I can,
You talking about the concert?
Was that the concert she said that was about?
Well, like I said, Luce, can I join your show, Miss Special Guest? Yeah, I guess you can. He wants to know if he says here, I'll call back, put me right on the air, and me and my guests will join you. Then we won't be beefing. Okay? There was a concert. Okay. Thanks, Donna. So yes, Lou, you can try calling back. Dory, I'm going to be routing this call right through to you as a guest on this show who wants to be on our show.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll try to see how this goes, Lou. What I'll do is I'm going to transfer the call over to Dory, and she's going to put it on the speaker like she normally would do, and then from there, hopefully it'll work fine. So, go ahead, call in. All hailing frequencies are open, Captain. Go ahead, Lou. Hold on a second. I'll connect you over, okay? 1 minute.
Hello, Lou? Hello?
Good evening, you're on the phone direct with Chase and I'll get home. Oh, I'm going to find what was fucking going on. How may I help you or hurt you? Paper, flossy, junk man.
How can you what? Talking between the two of them.
They're talking on their channel. And if you got, so obviously they can hear us sort of interesting. Let me get on the regular speakers. I'll make this talk join at the same time. Right.
You know,
if
you're not entertaining, well, if you're not entertaining, it doesn't get warm. I'm a broadcaster.
Well, I just wanted to say one thing before we get too far. You guys, if you want us to ask something or answer something, you're going to have to give us a little bit of time to answer, because you guys are bouncing back and forth so fast between each other that we don't even get a chance to get a word in edgewise.
If they stop, they get the leader. They just took them down for no reason or what? If they stop, they get the leader. I think 100%,
okay, so what we're hearing in the background, I'm going to turn this down a bit so I can explain this to my audience. What we're hearing here is Lou has got us on his show. He's got a caller on his program. And so what's happening is that his sound, his guests are asking questions to him. So until his guest and him takes a break, we can't actually answer anything because we can't even get a word in edgewise. Please understand the way our speakerphone works, it's very simple. When you're talking, we can't say anything at all. So we have two choices. One, we could switch to the handset, which is an option. Or, like I said unto him on the screen, is that if he wants to ask a question, he's going to have to give us a few seconds time to answer the question. What's that doing? All right. Well, let me silence this call for a bit. We did not expect we're going to have multiple calls coming through, and it gets really confusing. So what we're going to try to do is, Lou, if you would be willing to type your questions or your guest questions, it makes it a lot easier. Or if you guys can quietly give us a few seconds time to respond. Now, obviously, there is a delay. It's just kind of like when you're trying to make a phone call to the moon. It's actually bouncing off the satellites in space and going through fiber optic cables. So it's not like in real time there's a delay. And so that's kind of slowing us down. Any comments, questions, Dory? Anybody saying anything?
Wait. I'm sorry. My guest flipped out on me. I can call you with a different guest later.
Okay. If you want to call us yourself, it might be easier, because make sure when you call that you give us a few seconds for us to get the question before we can answer it, because the phone, your speech or your output from your phone takes precedence. We're not trying to ignore you, but now here's the good news. We already demonstrated it's not the phone system dropping calls right now. The phone system is working A-okay. Anything more from Donna? Because I did. She mentioned to me that it was a
concert. Don't let him get to you. I think he's just trying to put you on his show. He said he was looking for a talent.
Well, maybe he's looking for a talent. I don't deny that. But what gets confusing is when he has a guest on and the guest's asking him questions. And then what happens is that guest is asking questions and we're hearing it, but we can't speak back to them when they're talking. And so that's where it gets very hard, and this applies to anybody when you call. Whenever you call, it's just like CB radio. One person talks at a time. So that, because there's a satellite delay and shit, you're going to have to just be very patient. Like me and Dory are doing right now. We are talking, and then she talks. Correct? Yeah, that makes sense. It makes sense to me, too. Okay. While we're waiting for that, let me just let you know what's going on right now. First of all, the time. Michelle was checking her live stream, see how many people are calling. We know we have Donna on.
Michelle.
What?
Lou said, he said, I can concert in 15 minutes. My viewers love your show.
Okay. Don't forget to tell them to subscribe.
764 are on them term now.
Tell them to subscribe to our channel on YouTube. It's so easy. Just tell them to search for Michele Marie Delaney. That's M I C H E-L-A.
I have it right here.
I'm just spelling it for you. M-A-R-I-E space D as in dog, A-L-E-N-E. The exact channel URL for those who want the direct link is www.
Michele, I can't write that fast while you're talking.
All right, I'll talk slower. Well, don't forget, we got people can hear it too. www.youtube. That's YouTube. .com / USER / B as in boy I C H E L A 3. That's the number 3. And hit enter, and that will bring you right to my YouTube channel. And don't forget to click the subscribe button and click on the little bell so you can receive your notifications. Now, if you're watching this, you can also click on the to subscribe NASQ square that's in the lower right-hand corner of most viewer screens. Click on that. It'll bring you right to my channel so you can subscribe that way. So again, there's two ways to go. Either the long way with the URL like I just gave, or go to the subscribe NASQ, the little blue square in the lower right-hand corner, such as on Google Chrome and some Firefox browsers and probably even Internet Explorer as well. Just click on that. And I'll bring you right to my channel where you can click the subscribe tab. And don't forget that to click on the little bell to receive on-the-fly notifications of any new material that is being posted. Amen. Amen. And let's see. He might say you might have all those people, but how come right now the only people actually watching this is us and one person? I don't know. Probably other people watching it that are not actually on YouTube directly. Right, so like his channel is probably, like you said, relaying a program over to them so that he can watch them online. Yes, okay. And first of all, I am very happy to have everybody on the stream and watching these videos. And don't forget, tomorrow we will again be doing another live stream. Okay? So, and of course we have our vlogs for today and our vlog from yesterday. And, so that's pretty good. Yep. And let me see how we're doing here. I can say right now, the good news is that the system is working much better now with Frontier. Yes, guys, sometimes the old ways are still the best ways, which is to have an analog telephone line for calls because people can call in to the studio. Dory, did I leave my chocolate chip cookies in that room?
I just ate the last two.
You ate the last one?
Two!
Oh. Oh, I don't see it here. I don't see it here. It's obviously somewhere. Maybe it should have been another computer. Whatever. So you say you don't have them?
I ate the last two!
Okay, okay.
And Lou said he's going to be calling again.
Okay, so they're good though, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, speaking of the last three, we're going to do all these soda bottles here on the floor. Oh, one's empty. Yeah, one's empty. So we can throw that one in the garbage. Yep. Now, let's see. What are we going to talk about? Well, like I said, as far as the deep state gate that Alex Jones has been bringing up to my attention, because we got 5 minutes left, guys. So, last call. We have 5 minutes left. It is 5:54 Eastern Time. Last call for the night. If you have a call, you like to make a call real quick, this is the time. You got 5 minutes. 5 single minutes to call in, okay? And after that, we're going to get ready to wrap it up. So, if you didn't get to us today, that's okay, because we will get to you tomorrow if you call us tomorrow. Of course, we can leave the, I don't know how the chat's going to be left open. I suppose the chat can still be left open for a bit, Dory. Would you still be on the field chats for after we log off the video? Dory.
What?
Okay. Because I don't know how that's going to work, but I suppose the chat will still be working. So what you can do is, if somebody does not call in approximately 5 minutes, you'll just sit around for a little... Oh, got a call. I'll take care of that.
Hello, how can I help you? Alright, hold on a minute. I'll transfer you. Hang on.
Go ahead, caller.
What's up with you?
What's that? Well, I think right now it gets kind of confusing is that...
That's what kind of store is it, man?
Okay, well, right now, Lou, I was going to say was is that...
I don't really talk about it because I don't want to connect what I do online.
Let me... It's kind of breaking there here for a minute. Okay. Oh, boy. I'm all tangled up. Okay. Excuse me, Lou. Excuse me. Hello. Excuse me, Lou. I'm trying to say something.
He don't hear you.
Do you want... Does your guest... Okay, does your guest have any questions? Because I'm going to get ready to wrap it up, and this is the last call for tonight. Does your guest have any questions? You know what you should do is get an E&M splitter circuit hooked up. I can get one built easy enough. Well, anyway, I was just going to say that we're going to get ready to wrap this up for now. And let me put this back on speakerphone so that everybody can hear what you're saying, because I turned my speakerphone off because it is, like I said, when you talk, I can't talk. That's just the way the speakerphone works. So I wanted to, first of all, thank you for calling the show. And what we'll have to do is we're going to have to sit down and organize this a bit better in the future. Because this gets kind of confusing to everybody because nobody knows what each other is doing. I don't know if he's talking to me or to his guest. I can't tell which one he's talking to. What I was going to say was is that what you and I can do is we'll see if we can try to better organize this for tomorrow's live stream. For those of your audience who do not know, we will be having a live stream tomorrow starting around 4:55 p.m. and they'll run until about 6 o'clock tomorrow night. Conversely, the same thing for next week. I don't know if we're going to do Thursday every day, every week, but we definitely did plan to do Friday every week. So, like last Friday would have been great because it would have been, maybe we need to do is better organize things somehow, but I'm not sure how we're going to do this because we have, to come up with a better way to, coordinate all the calls between two different programs. Well, for right now, I just want to let my audience know that officially it's time to get ready to wrap it up. And thank you very much for calling. And for all my audience who kind of feels like you kind of missed out, I'm really sorry about that. But we will see each other next week. We'll see each other next week on Friday. So for now, I want to thank everybody for calling. So, we'll see everybody soon. Okay? Bye-bye. Bye-bye, everybody. Okay, we're clear. Let me just go ahead.